I had the privilege this evening of choosing any katha because the host and the hostess, they said to me, read whatever you think will be fit the occasion. And what is the occasion? Members of the family, they're celebrating many different things. One of the things that they're celebrating first and foremost is the memory of all of the Pitras and all of those who have died and left and gone to the great beyond. And something else they're celebrating is a retirement. I'm not going to tell you who retired, because when you look at the retiree, he looks younger than most of us, even me. So I'm not going to tell you who retired, but I'm going to say that we're celebrating a retirement. This evening, our katha comes from the Shiva Mahapuran. And we have heard this katha many times before. This evening, to reiterate what you already know, let us listen as the Shiva Mahapuran begins to tell us very beautifully. Har Har Jai Shankar, Om Har Har. सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्य वरणे कामातरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सरा शुक्लाम्बरवरणं देवा शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजा प्रसन्नवर्णं न्याये सर्वविघ्नोपशान्ते ॐ नमः शिवाय ॐ नमः शिवाय ॐ नमः शिवाय देव व्याप सुदान दक्ष का हरे
हर हर जय शंकर ओम हर 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 जय शंकर ओम हर हर
सात नदी कयूट कह गए and all devis, they were all beautifully dressed and they were all sitting on the Pushpak Viman, their celestial chariots, and they were all flying in one direction. All devatas, all devis, they were all seated on their Pushpak Viman, their celestial chariots. They were all beautifully dressed and they were all heading in one direction. This evening, all members of this family, can I say my family, they got dressed and everybody looked beautiful and everybody was heading in one direction to the temple. So to all devatas and all devis, they were beautifully dressed and they were all heading in one direction. But heading in this direction, they were flying over Mount Kailash, this place where Lord Shiva lives. Have you ever seen somebody dressed and ready to go someplace and you become inquisitive, you want to know where they're going? You want to know how come you did not get an invitation? You want to know what prayers or what function they're attending? And then when you see them dressed, because you're so envious or jealous that they're going to something that you were not invited to, you look at them and you say, well, you're not looking too good for that occasion. You're wearing the wrong clothes. And so you dampen the spirit of the person who's already dressed and ready to go. Have you ever done that before? When you're in the temple, talk the truth. We are all Trinidadians and we are real critics of everything. We criticize and we condemn everything, even the good thing. And so Sati Devi, she sat next to Lord Shiva. And Sati Devi, seeing all of the chariots going, Sati Devi, what caught her eyes is what the Devis were wearing. What catches the eye of a woman? Anything that is beautiful, it catches her eye. True or not? While the world calls a man handsome, a woman becomes attracted to her husband not because of being handsome, but being because of beautiful. True or not? She sees him to be beautiful inside and outside. The world sees him to be handsome and fat and dark and all different adjectives. The world sees him. But she sees him as something beautiful. Is that true, wife? Well, Baba, when I now meet him, he was beautiful. And then I don't know what happened after that. What caught the eye and the attention of Sati Devi is how beautifully bedecked all the other Devis were. Mother, have you ever seen somebody wearing an outfit and you say, I have to get one just like that? Have you ever seen somebody wearing jewelry and you say, I want something just like that? Have you ever seen somebody wearing a glasses and you say, I want one just like that? Have you ever seen somebody with a cell phone and you say, I want one just like that? It looks easy to use. And so Sati Devi is seeing the beautiful disposition of all the Devis. Sati Devi, she became inquisitive and she wanted to know where they were going. Sati Devi turned and she looked at Lord Shiva and she says, oh Lord Shiva, all Devatas and all Devis, they are going to some place. But it seems as though we have not been invited. Oh Lord Shiva, do you have any idea where they are going to? And Lord Shiva smiles. He says, oh Sati, they're going to the home of your father, Daksha Prajapati. And Daksha, he is hosting a yajna. And so all Devatas and all Devis, they were invited. But oh Sati, we were not invited. You and I, we were not invited. And Sati Devi looked at Lord Shiva. Hearing the words of Lord Shiva, Sati Devi, she begins to speak. Listen to her words to Lord Shiva. This is what she says to him.
Anga sumiru ho vachan sunai sati kaha dukha dalitra na pai dekar kaise ho sarva hari va binat ho devi milna na deka jai shiva shankar Jai Mahadeva, Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva.
Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva, Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva.
Pravish karat par uska hari ki ki sab devan devi na deki usne puche kiro kahari ka pita kaha apni amrit na deka jai shiva shankar jai mahadeva jai shiva shankar jai mahadeva
jai shiva shankar jai mahadeva jai shiva shankar jai mahadeva
Sati Devi looked at Lord Shiva and she says, what do you mean we were not invited? Have you ever heard of some family member having a function and everybody else gets invited and you didn't get invited? How does it feel? In time gone by, when family had a function, especially a big function where even strangers are invited to, and I was not invited, I felt sad and sorry, and I felt some feeling, I can't explain it. But now, do you know when nobody invites me, I feel good? Now when nobody invites me, I feel good. And even though they invite me, I try not to go. Even though they invite me, I try not to go. I don't know if that makes sense. Sati Devi, she looks at Lord Shiva and Sati Devi says, oh Lord Shiva, I do not need an invitation to go to the home of my father. I can go to that place anytime I choose to. I can go to that place anytime I choose to, and so I do not need an invitation. Should we only go when we are invited? Hello? Do you only attend functions that you are invited to? Have you ever gone to a function with somebody else's invitation? Have you ever been invited by a guest to attend a function? And so Sati Devi, uttering these words, what will happen? Listen, it tells us.
Ajaneri mehe hamaine sa Gyan ka suraj chamekari bhagavan
Sati Devi. Against the wishes of Lord Shiva, Sati Devi, she recites the act. And what does she do? Listen, it tells us. Sati Devi decides to ignore the words of Lord Shiva, thinking and taking for granted that she could attend any function at the home of her father. And Sati Devi, she went and she got herself dressed in the most beautiful clothes that she could find. And Sati Devi made her way to her father's home. Sati Devi noticed that her father, he was standing at the door. And Sati Devi noticed that he was hugging and kissing and welcoming everybody who came. But Sati Devi noticed that when he saw her, he turned his head and he walked in the opposite direction. Have you ever been in the company of somebody you know and they pretend they don't know you? Hello? Let me change that question to one that we could relate to. Have you ever pretended not to know somebody though you know them? And we are all guilty of that. He paid no heed to Sati Devi, and so this angered Sati a little, but she remained quiet. What do we do when we get angry? What should we do when we get angry? Hello? What do you do when you get angry? Husband, will you know when your wife is angry? Baba, when she becomes angry, she just have to watch the pot and it's going to store for itself. That's what our anger can do. Wife, when you know when your husband is angry? Can you tell? Sati Devi felt humiliated. And so, being humiliated, she felt angry. But she remained quiet. One of the most difficult things for us to do is to remain quiet. One of the most difficult things for us to do is not react. We react and then we regret the actions. We act and then we think. We do not think before we act. We act and then we begin to think. And all of us, we are guilty of that. And so Sati Devi, she looked at her father, and though he did not talk to her, Sati Devi spoke to him. Have you ever tried to talk to a person who is not talking to you? In my whole life, I have known so much people who don't talk to other people that I can't begin to list it or name it. And we stop talking, or we stop having affiliation and association with people for the most pettiest, insignificant things. True or not? We allow the most petty, insignificant thing to create the biggest disturbance with our relations with others. All because of our ego, and all because of not knowing how to remain quiet. And so Sati Devi, she looked at her father and she says, I noticed that there were seats assigned for all devatas and all devis. Where the seats for myself and Lord Shiva? And the father looked at Sati and he says, what seat are you talking about? You and Lord Shiva, you were not invited. And so I did not create an asana upon which you will sit. The devatas and the devis started to laugh. It is so easy for us to look at others in distress and laugh at them. True or not? It is so easy for us to look at somebody else in distress and make a joke out of them. But have we given thought that their fate could be ours one day? Have we given thought that by laughing at them, we have secured that somebody will laugh at us in return? Because what goes around? And every time you plant a seed, you know who will eat the fruit? Who will eat the fruit? Not a stranger. You will eat the fruit from the seeds that you have planted. And so Sati Devi, the devatas started to laugh, and Sati Devi felt even more humiliated. Have you ever been in a predicament where everybody watches you and laugh? You cut your hair and you spend a whole day by the hairdresser. And you come home and the children look at you and they start to laugh. They say, Mommy, what did the hairdresser do? She shock you? How are you here standing up? And you have been dreaming of having this hairstyle. And everybody begins to laugh at you. I always love to see ladies when they do their hair, especially when they're going to a function like a wedding. And especially when they do their hair the night before, so they have to sit up and sleep. They can't lie down. They have to sit down and sleep because they don't want their curls to spoil. And we go to the beach. It is Kartik. And one of my aunts say to me, she say, I'll bathe, you know, but I'm not wetting my head. I say, why? You're supposed to bow to Ganga Devi before you go. And you have to wet your head. She say, all my dye will run out. She said, I dyed my hair yesterday and you can't put that seawater on my head. I said to her, no problem. As we enter into the water, I tell everybody, I say, put your hands together. Let us pray. Close your eyes. And you think of God. And I take my lota of milk and I pour it on her head. And everybody praying and she quarreling. What is important? Tonight, I want to tell you, while outer beauty might be important, inner beauty is more important than outer beauty. It is better that your outside look anyhow, but your inside is pure. It is better that your disposition on the outside looks dark and ugly, but your disposition on the inside must be crystal clear and pure. And Sati Devi, being humiliated by all devatas, what Sati Devi does, listen, it tells us.
माँ तेरी ममता कितनी प्यारी कितना प्यारी जगाती है कितना प्यारी जगाती है सती हो माई बिरता देख दिया हो माँ आसन बेती अगणित लेके देखा होता शंकर सोहि शंकर होइ दक्ष सुयज्ञ विदाता
Sati Devi looked around and she was in search of a place where she could sit. Have you ever gone to a function and there's so much people and you can't find a chair to sit down? Have you ever gone to a funeral and you have to stand up outside because there is limited seats? I'm doing the funeral and I'm saying, nothing of this world belongs to us. One day we will die and we will leave everything. And there is a big uproar outside. Two ladies, they're fighting. So I stop the sermon and I inquire, why are they fighting? They're fighting for a chair. One lady was sitting on that chair and so she went to get a bottle of water and another lady came and she sat down. But she can't walk, she's walking with a walker. And the lady came back with her water and she said, that is my chair and I want it. And big fight for a chair. And it was so bad that I had to leave the funeral and I had to go outside where the two ladies were. And I looked at the lady with the water in her hand and I said, Mama, you have 2 foot and you could stand up. This lady is walking with a walker. She said, I don't care, that's my chair. I said, Mama, but nothing in this world is ours. And why are you quarreling for a chair? You're disturbing the whole funeral. She said, Pandit, you don't understand. I don't care. And I said, Mama, can you do me one favor? Come inside, I'll find some place for you to sit down. She said, this is my chair and I'm sitting here because I could get breeze and I don't care, you and she and everybody could go inside, I'm not moving. And in my mind, I looked at her, I remembered that some time ago there was a house speaker who didn't want to give up her seat. And I looked at her, I said, Mama, you're reminding me of somebody I know. She said, I don't even care about that too, Pandit. I look behind the chair and I'm seeing R. I say, Mama, what's your name? Sumati, something is her name. I said, behind this chair, Mark, R. That's not your name. This is not your chair. She said, let me go home, eh? And she gets upset. Have we given thought that just like that chair does not belong to her? So too, there are many things that we hold in our hand that we think is ours, but it is really not. Have we given thought that there are many things we hold in our hand and we say is mine and it doesn't belong to us? Everybody thinking about house and land. One day you're dead and leave house and land right behind. Everybody thinking about money and money and money. And one day will come, you could have a mountain of money and it will be of no use to you. Everybody thinking about things of the material world. And one day will come when nothing of the material world will be of any use to you. And so Sati Devi, looking for a place where she will sit, the only vacant place was in the Havan Kund. The fire was blazing. And Sati Devi, she went and she sat in the fire. Have you ever entered into a place and you feel as though you walk into the oven? All eyes are on you. And all attention is on you. And you're as though you walked into the lion den. The lion waiting to eat you. Have you ever felt like that before? Sati Devi sat in the fire and the fire started to exhume, to eat, to destroy the body of Sati. And as Sati's body started to burn, Sati started to scream with pain. She started to scream with pain. And who will hear the cry of Sati? Lord Shiva. Hearing the cry of his wife, Lord Shiva rushes to this place where the yajna is happening. I want to tell you with no apology tonight. You see, a husband and a wife never, ever, 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 ever get involved in their business. You agree with me? You see, a husband and a wife never, ever, ever lose the key to your mind to get involved in their business. Baba, I don't like him and I don't want to see him again. Call him and tell him for me. And you give a paragraph. And poor Baba, call your husband and tell him. And when you leave by Baba, you go on back home by your husband. And everybody vexed with you know who? There are many things I have stopped getting involved in. I hear, but I pretend I'm deaf. I see, but I pretend I'm blind. I know, but I pretend I don't. And so Sati Devi, sitting in the Havan Kund, she begins to scream. And Lord Shiva appears. Lord Shiva wastes no time. Seeing Sati in the fire, Lord Shiva rushes. And the Kadha says, as he lifts the body of Sati, fragments of the body fell in different directions and different devis were formed and many different explanations are given. But Lord Shiva keeps the skull of Sati and places it around his neck on his mala as a token to remember Sati. But Daksh Prajapati, the father of Sati, the host of the Yajna, Lord Shiva uses his trishul and he severs the head of Daksh Prajapati. He does not leave Daksh Prajapati without a head, but he places the head of a goat on the body of Daksh Prajapati. And he says, "Oh Daksha, your mouth worked, but it worked for all the wrong reasons. And you have insulted the wrong person. Have we given thought that one day we will talk to the wrong person the wrong way? Have we given thought that one day we will say the wrong thing to the wrong person and we'll get in trouble?" And so he says, the goat mouth is always busy. But you know, busy doing what? Chewing its own food and minding its own business. Minding its own business. If we would only learn how to mind our own business, life will become smooth sailing, you know. You all know that? But we are so caught up minding everybody else's business that we have forgotten to mind our own business. And then time comes to an end, and then we realize we have done nothing for ourselves. And so Daksha, having the head of the goat, what will happen? At that time, Lord Shiva makes a vow that he will never get married again. You ever hear the little boy say, "I'm not getting married"? You ever hear the little girl say, "I'm not getting married"? And one little girl passed across, and you know what happened? Kuch kuch hota hai. Can't wait to put a date for the wedding. Can't wait to live with that person. And you have forgotten what you said. So too, Lord Shiva has made a vow that he will not become married. And at that time, what will happen? There is a demon praying to Lord Shiva. Who is he? What is he saying? These are his words to Lord Shiva.
Jai Shiva, Jai Shiva, Jai Shiva Shankara.
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 Jai Shiva, Jai Shiva, Jai Shiva Shankara. Mahadayalu Param Kripalu,
Mahadayalu Param Kripalu,
Mahadayalu Param Kripalu,
Mahadayalu Param Kripalu,
Hara 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 Hara.
Hara, hara, hara.
har 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 har
har har har har har har har har
Jai Shiva Jai Shiva Jai Shiva Shankar जय गिरिजापति दीन दयाला
जय गिरिजापति दीन दयाला
जय गिरिजापति दीन दयाला
जय गिरिजापति दीन दयाला
हर 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 har 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 har
har har har har har har har har
jai shiva jai shiva jai shiva shankar
jai shiva jai shiva jai shiva shankar
o jai shiva jai shiva jai shiva shankar
o jai shiva
At that time, there is a demon praying to Lord Shiva. And at that time, Lord Shiva appears in front of the demon. The demon looks at Lord Shiva and he says, Lord Shiva, you came because you are pleased with me. Then bless me with the Varadhan, bless me with the gift that the only time I will die is that I will be destroyed by the hands of your son. The demon knows that Lord Shiva has no wife. So the demon thinks that having a son is an impossible task for Lord Shiva. And so he says, bless me with the Varadhan, that I will only die at the hands of your son, O Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva, who has made a vow never to get married, the demon will only die at the hands of the son of Lord Shiva. Eva must do, so shall it be, Lord Shiva says. And so the demon, being blessed with the Varadhan, the demon begins to create havoc. The demon creates distress. Do you know that there are some people, they can't live their life peaceful. They always think about what trouble they could make. They always think about what news they could carry. They always think about what bad they could do, rather than do something good. You know anybody like that? Don't answer. There's some people, they could talk real nice, but they choose to quarrel all the time. So you're afraid to talk to them. You're afraid to have any conversation with them because you do not know what their reaction will be. You cannot tell what their reaction will be. Eva must do, so shall it be. And so the demon begins to create havoc. He enters into the heavens and he enters into Shivalok and he enters everywhere and he goes creating distress. Have you ever seen the stray cat? The stray cat enters and it comes into your home. And what the stray cat will do? Goes into your kitchen. And the stray cat begins to eat before anybody could go in the pot. Have you ever encountered that before? So to the demon enters and creates distress. And as the demon begins to create distress, the devatas, they become worried. They know that only through the son of Lord Shiva, this demon will be destroyed. The devatas stop singing the praises of Lord Shiva. And the devatas begin to praise the Devi. They begin to call the name of the Devi. What are they saying to her?
सुनो मेरे देवी पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पारण पाया माँ तेरा पारण पाया बोलो
जाना रे अलग
पुरुषाय विद्महे महादेवाय धीमहि तन्नो रुद्र प्रचोदयात् ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय। भगवान शंकर की मापिका मगन का करनी है देखो और नाश का दिया करनी है उसका सा दक्ष किया होकर बकरी का सिर पीने वाले हैं। शिव शंकर की प्रगट की करते हैं सारी की करेंगे देख और देव दानव की जानते हैं भगवान शंकर की प्यास प्रार्थना करेंगे सुदूर का करनी क्रिया है देख और प्रार्थना की भगवान शंकर की प्रगट होते हैं देख और अश्वाद कीने है और देवता की झुक जाते का देवन प्रार्थना की करेंगे हैं। हमी का भक्षों का देख और उसका का शरीर का बिनती है देख और भगवती माता की प्रगट उनके हैं हेमावन के देख और राका की तटने करने वाले बोलो सुनो मेरे देवी पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पारन पाया माँ तेरा पारन पाया
सुनो मेरी देवी पर्वतवासिनी तेरा पारन पाया तेरा पारन पाया
माँ तेरा पारन पाया
The devatas go to this place where the Devi lives and they begin to beg the Devi. Devi, you must come. You must take your appearance. Devi, you must manifest. And so you must become married to Lord Shiva once more. So that you'll be able to bring forth children. And so your child will be able to destroy the demon. The Devi, she is hesitant. But down on the earth, Himavant and Maina Devi, the mountain king and his wife, they have been praying to have a child. And the Devi says, they were praying and they were so sincere that if she has to take birth, she will go in their home. Tonight, if God has an opportunity to choose any one of our homes to go to, whose home you think he'll go to tonight? Tonight, if Devi has a choice or a chance to choose any one of our homes to go to, which home you think she'll go to? Hello? Which home you think she'll go to? Long ago, you could have dropped into anybody's home and you were welcome. Now you have to call and make an appointment and chances are, when you take your time and you go, the gate lock and they're not home, though they know you're coming. Have you ever experienced that before? Don't answer. In 2019, you're ringing in the doorbell and they're seeing you outside, but they're peeping through, not the curtain again, the camera. Seeing you on the screen. And seeing you and saying, man, lame, ring the bell. I'm not answering. Have you ever done that to anybody? Have you ever done that to anybody? See them by the gate and leave them right there? Oh God, don't do anybody that. That's not a nice thing. The Devi manifests and she goes down. Being born, she appears into the home of this mountain king and his wife, and they name her Parvati. From having the name Sati, they now give the Hari name Parvati. Parvati quickly blossoms into a beautiful girl. And blossoming into a beautiful girl, Parvati, words cannot describe her beauty. Tonight, how beautiful are you? Tonight, how handsome are you? Hello? How beautiful are you? One of my aunts came from all the way Austria. Priyagya. Auntie Sue, how beautiful are you? One of my aunts came all the way from Norway. Auntie Radhika, how beautiful are you? One of my aunt came all the way from Vancouver. Auntie Dolly, how beautiful are you? One of my aunt came from St. Joseph. Auntie Joyce, how beautiful are you? She says, I'm 100 plus. One of my aunt came all the way from the United States of Karapichaima. Moles, how beautiful are you? Beauty is not something found on the outside, but beauty is something that emanates from the inside. Agreed? Do you all agree with that? She was beautiful and words could not describe her beauty, the way she spoke. She was elegant, beyond elegant. And so, the Devatas had to do something to introduce Lord Shiva to Parvati. You listen to the old people talk and they say, Baba, when I was small, my father come home one day and say, you're going to get married in a month from now, and I don't see the boy. And I asked my father, what the boy look like? He say, he living, he's a human being, and he breathing. That's all you need to know. And he working, and he have a good job. And Baba, on the day of the wedding, when I peep through the crease in the board, in the house, and I see there's a black man pull up in this car, Baba, I start to sweat. I say, in the night, I'll have to get a touch line to see him. But Baba, 50 years and 60 years and 70 years, and we live good. Every single day was a new day. And every single day was a little challenge, you know. But we know how to cut and fit. You ever hear the old people talk? We know how to cut and we know how to fit and we know how to make do with whatever we have. Now you're dating for 15 years. And you get married and you divorce before 15 days. In 2019, you're so careful, you choose and you choose and you choose until you choose, you know what? You choose that which will add no value to your life. You choose that which will add no value to your life. And so Parvati Devi, she was most beautiful. The Devatas had to do something. Parvati, every single day, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. She's calling the name of Lord Shiva. But Lord Shiva is pretending he's not hearing. The Devatas, they do something. What do they do? Listen.
Deva Samanaha Bhagavate Rupa Usika Hari Kar Parvati Rupa Mijana Hotaha Devata Samana Kama Hadevaha Binata Hodeka Va Apani Apa Mana Hadeki Koni Shanaha Bana Tadeki Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva, Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva,
Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva, Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Mahadeva.
The Dev with us someone, a being whose name is Kamadev. Who is Kamadev? Kamadev is the god of love. Listen to how I'm saying it. Love. Kamadev is the god of love. And so the Devatas summon Kamadev. They look at Kamadev and they say, oh Kamadev, you have an easy job. And your job is to make Lord Shiva like Parvati Devi. Your job is to make a connection, a link between Lord Shiva and Parvati. You ever tried to make people talk to people they're not talking to? And they become good friend and you become the enemy? Have you ever experienced that? Anybody comes to me and they say, well, Baba, they ain't talking to me. I say, well, girl, say thank God. Say thank God. Baba, how you could say that? But I want them to talk to me. I say, well, take up your phone and call them. If they vex with you, tell them you're not vexed with them and you talk to them. Anybody I know vex with me, I take up the phone and I call them, you know. I never send a message. I never send a message. I have learned to stop sending messages because messages get you in more trouble. Agreed? And I am nobody's messenger. I am not dropping any message because the messenger always gets. You know? I don't know what you all say up here, but in San Fernando, we say the messenger gets shoot. I don't know what you all say up here. I'm telling you what we say down south. I am carrying no message for nobody. I have something to tell you, I could tell you myself. And sometimes if I tell you, I will apologize because I know you'll get vexed. I say, I want to apologize before I tell you what I'm going to tell you, but I have to tell you. And so, Kamadev comes with the arrow of love. And he places his arrow to his bow, and Kamadev shoots the arrow. And the arrow pierces through the heart of Lord Shiva. The arrow of love. But as Kamadev shoots the arrow, Lord Shiva opens his eyes at that time. And he sees the arrow coming towards him. And this angers Lord Shiva. You ever turn and watch somebody having a conversation and you see your name on their lip and you know they're talking about you? Have you ever experienced that? Hello? Every Trinidadian would have experienced that. True or not? Somebody's talking to you right there, you know? Good, good, good. And they turn their back and then they're talking about you. To you and then about you. And then turn back and talking to you. Kuchi, kuchi, ku. You're my friend. And saying all the bad things about you. Lord Shiva, out of anger, a flame emanates out of his third eye. And the flame goes in the direction of Kamadev, who has shot an arrow. And this flame burns Kamadev, the god of love. His body slumps to the ground and turns into ashes. And now Kamadev, the god of love, he has been destroyed. The wife of Kamadev, she begins to cry. Who is she? Listen, it tells us.
Ratika hasu meru ho Shankar daya Binata hari karma hatmana gaya Rupaha prema andarana koi Ratiko jalane bikarna hoi बारिका निज संकट होए मुसुना हरे कर किया कहा होए जय शिव शंकर जय महादेवा जय शिव शंकर जय महादेवा
जय शिव शंकर जय जय शिव शंकर जय महादेवा.
Rati, the wife of Kamadev, the god of love, rushes to Lord Shiva and she holds on to the feet of Lord Shiva. And Rati says, Lord Shiva, how would I live without my husband? Wife, Have you ever given thought that if something happens to your husband, what will you do? What will you do if something happens to your husband? Husband, have you given thought? What if something happens to your wife? What will you do? Baba, I'll have a 7 nights Ramayana jag. Do you know there are some people, they pray genuinely, God bless my husband, God bless my wife. And do you know genuinely there are some people who say, God, please, I'm begging you, help me. Wife, if ever you prayed for your husband to death, look out. He outliving you. And husband, if ever you prayed for your wife to die, you're in real trouble. She'll be doing your funeral. Don't pray for her to die. Baba, all I want is for her to stop quarreling. But then stop doing things for her to quarrel. Then start listening a little bit. And she wouldn't have to quarrel. Try to help her and try to give her a little attention. And then she had no cause to tell you anything. One day, take up the broom and help her sweep the house. Baba, if I sweep the house, my wife could faint away. You ask the husband to bring the broom and he don't even know if the house have a broom. You ask the husband to put the clothes in the dryer. And he go and put the clothes in the dryer and he never turn it on. Because you didn't tell him turn on the switch too. You ask the husband where the heater, the ironing is in the house. And he said, we are none of that. But the clothes iron, you know. Every day they get crispy ironed clothes. There's some wives who love their husband so much that they spray starch. You know? Starch. They should stiff like cardboard. And when the husband walk out the house, he looking crisp and brand new. You know, long time they used to starch everything. You all remember that? Your shirt and your pants and got a little starch. You ask the husband, how your shirt looking so white, boy? He said, me, I know it new. And that's because your wife washed the shirt with blue. You know what's blue? Well, in 2019, we don't have blue again, but we have blue wash now. We have something called blue wash. So when you're washing white clothes, you put blue wash in there. Long time there was scrubbing board and blue soap. See how we advanced? We have advanced in many ways, but we have remained backwards in many ways too. We have gone forward in many ways, but we have remained backwards in many ways too. And so, Lord Shiva, hearing the cry of Rati, the wife of Kamadev, the god of love, Rati says, how can I live without my husband? Bring him back to life. Bring him back to life, I'm begging you. Lord Shiva says, he has been burnt. Rati, he has been burnt, and so I cannot bring him back to life. And Lord Shiva takes the ashes of Kamadev and he begins to rub it on his skin. And he says, your husband is the husband, the god of love. He will not be seen, but he will be felt. He will not be seen physically, but he will be felt. How does love look? How does love look? Hello? How does love look? Lord Shiva says, Kamadev, the god of love, will not be seen, but he will be felt. The little boy says, oh God, I see she and I fall in love. I say, well, you're in real trouble. He say, why? I say, because one day you will fall out of love. Anything you fall into, you could fall out of. Or what dharma says to us, you never fall in love with anybody, but you grow to love. You grow to love, and every day your love and your affection should grow. And so, Rati, though her husband cannot be seen physically, he will be felt. And Rati, she feels happy to hear this. Tonight the world is celebrating love. Tonight the Western world is celebrating love. Valentine's. You got a rose today? You're lucky. But if you didn't tell your husband, when you go back home, tell him. Tell him that I told you. That Valentine's is not the 14th of February only. It is every day. You got chocolate today and you feel nice? Tell the person who is giving you the chocolate. that a day to show love and appreciation is not only the 14th of February, but is every day. Every day should be Valentine's Day. How much chocolate do you eat on the 14th of February? And so, Rati Devi secures the Varadaran that a husband, though he will not be seen, he will be felt. Tonight, we celebrate the life of the Pitras of this family. Though they cannot be seen, they are always felt. Though we cannot see them physically, we feel them. We know that they are around. In this family, we were privileged to have one of the best grandmothers you could ever find. But in this family, we were privileged to have the best Aji and the best Nani that you could find as well. Some of you called her Aji, some of us called her Nani. I was a little child when Nani died, and that's our great grandmother. I was a little child when she died. But there are some thoughts of her that are etched in my mind that I will never get rid of till the day I die. Whenever Aji will see us, she will always say, "Look at your skin, your mother do bathe all you." And she always had a problem because she always thought that we were dark and we should be fair. So Aji, what she will do is that every time Aji goes to the river, everybody goes to find a stone that they will put by the jhandi, tofa, their dharan. But Aji will find a stone that she will use to scrub our skin. And when we think we are going for vacation, Aji will put us to stand by a drain where there was a concrete tub close to the bedroom where Uncle Sham slept in. And Aji says, "Stand up here." And Aji starts scrubbing us with the stone. I don't know how much of the children has enjoyed that. I tell you that that is something I will never forget. I say, "Aji, it hurt," and she says, "Hush your mouth." I say, "Aji, you're digging out the skin." She says, "No, if your mother used to bathe you every day, then I wouldn't have to do this." And I say, "Aji, but we black, how you want us to look?" She says, "Everybody else white, how you could be black?" And that's Aji. But you see, Mama, Mama died just recently. Just a few years ago, Mama died. Mama was one of the most gentlest, most loving, most divine human beings that you will ever meet. And I'm not telling you that because there are many other things that I could say, but this is the truth about her. The best food I have ever eaten in my whole life is the food that Mama cooked. Have you ever eaten dosti roti? She used to call it two-in-one. You all ever eat that before? When Mama makes the dosti roti, and she makes the pumpkin, and she puts some of the soaked anchar or kuchila, you're not only biting the mouthful of roti, you're biting your finger too. Because Mama had a way that when she cooked with love. She cooked with love. Mama had a unique way that she will cook something that was called mango takari. Not anchar. Mango takari with a little bit of curry. You all ever eat that? Uncle Sham, maybe one evening in this yagya we could cook mango takari like how Mama used to make it. And it came out like a jam where you could eat the anchar or the mango with roti and rice and anything you were eating. I was not privileged to know Papa. I was not privileged to have any dealings with him because I think he died very, very early. So I don't know him. I don't know much about him. I've seen him before in a picture and I've seen him before, but I don't know him. But this evening, just like Kamadev, he could not be seen, but he could be felt. Though Mama and Papa and Aji and all of them, they have left us physically, we can feel them. Tonight when we die, we must live our lives in such a way that our love, though we are not there physically, will still be felt. Our affection could still be felt in our physical absence. And so this evening, we remember Mama. Every time you see Mama, she's always wearing her urni. She always ties her urni on her head. And if Mama was going out, she'll pin the urni. But she'll never leave home without the urni. Mama wore the dress with the two pockets on the side. You all know that dress? She wore the dress that was made of this material with the little holes in it. What they call that material again? Angle. You all remember that? So she loved that material that even on the day of her funeral, that was what she wore. An outfit that was made with that. She was dressed in pink and she looked pink in her casket too. On the day of her cremation, she looked just like how she lived, beautiful and divine. How will we be looking when death comes knocking at our door? And those are memories that will forever be etched in our hearts. This evening we remember Mama and all the mothers of the family who has left. We remember Papa and all the fathers of the family that has left. We remember the mother and the father of Auntie Shobha. We ask that wherever their souls are, may their souls be granted peace and rest.